Feeling is certainly mutual, and listen to this crowd. They're certainly glad to see the Green Machine himself, the elite athlete, Mike Orlando. Of course, Rocco on the outside making reference to the NFL draft. Certainly, I mean, Dobbs giving up a lot of size to the elite athlete, Mike Orlando, but I mean, he is a former the MF Live champion, and there's always that X factor on the outside of Rocco, who certainly has more than his 2 cents to give in terms of his opinion. He seems to be throwing Dobbs a little bit off of his game here in the early going. But Orlando trying to sneak in there. Here the test of strength, but trying to use the leverage for a trip here, and a one count with a kip up, nicely done by Orlando, and well, to Dobbs' credit, he kicks up as well. Both men a great deal of athleticism, and oh, nice spin out sweep, and that gathers a one count. Now Dobbs with a sweep, he only gets one. Despite the size differential, both men very evenly matched up here in the early going. Dropped down by Orlando, leapfrog nicely done. Trying to flip over there and shoulder tackle, neither man moves. Like a game of Kenya top this, and now with a head of steam, and, oh, had the clothesline plan, dunked it. Overhead, belly to belly, suplex. And the speed as well as he goes in, explodes into the corner. Oh, but picked up into the fireman's carry. Wow! Look at the offense of the elite athlete. Right hand, nicely done here by Dobbs. Oh, another shoulder tackle. 275 pounder. Now Dobbs leaping over the top, and same idea here, but there's a spear. Tackling almost like a quarterback sack there is only a two point. Was a little bit of nonchalance there, and oh, now the elite athlete going to the second rope, the most dangerous rope, and now all of a sudden, wait, Rocco up here on the apron. Oh, but he brought the distraction, and that allowed Dobbs enough time to get to his feet. And now both men perched up here. Oh, dangerous territory here. And Dobbs, oh wow, top rope Frankensteiner. Oh, and you hear Rocco on the outside saying, it's good, referring to the kick there. And rolling into the corner is Dobbs, and again, see Rocco just adding that insult to injury. Oh, now just draping Orlando over the top rope. Ref, get in there. There we go. He's deceptively intense, is Dobbs. I mean, you look at him, you see he's 5'10", he's 190 pounds, but he's taking it to somebody who outweighs him by 85 pounds. And has a 6-inch height advantage. And leveling that giant with an elbow there. Thank you. chin lock here, also taking a second to just drag the fingers up against the nostrils, almost like securing a bowling ball. Thought I was in a league for 3 years, but oh, wow, out to the outside goes the elite athlete. Rocco physically interjecting himself, holding up Mike Orlando, and Dom looks perplexed, but in the favors. It looks like for the moment things are evened up here. Wow, what a kick to the dome. German suplex, no bridge, all impact. Head of steam here. He need him right in the jaw, and Dobbs is, he's got to be out on the outside. Oh! Tope Suicida through the middle rope. Well, that's why he was looked at as an NFL prospect, although he pretty much turned them away, and turning away the three count there is Dobbs kicking out with the right shoulder coming up. Oh no, Rocco back up on his feet, but stirred and a bit frustrated as well. Oh, trying for that crescent kick, and oh! That double leg face breaker, and able to hook the near leg for almost a three. Rocco celebrating on the outside, but that celebration premature. Oh, up into the fireman's carry. And he plants him there, but only a two. If he did, I wouldn't know the reference, but almost getting his hands on Rocco there. Meanwhile, springboard on the other side. Oh, there it is. Can't believe he just lost his Must be something about that hair. The ladies love it. Nick Camarado, in which he ended up losing in a triple threat match for that the MF Live Championship. I mean, folks like Plunkett the Ogre, Grey Wolf, the elite athlete Mike Orlando, and just to name a few. I mean, he's taken all types of challenges here. Quick leg sweep, only garnering a one count. Trying to utilize that speed and agility, trying to outquick the intense Gabriel. Oh, small package here. Near side cradle, I should say. Done. Trying to hook the crucifix. Able to do so. That only garners a two. Oh, to the Oklahoma roll. Referee out of position. Barely a one count. And the double leg takedown here. Sage trying to get this over with quickly. Leapfrog nicely done. Ducks the huge clothesline. Oh, he tried to roll back into a head scissor. Was able to catch it there, but before getting dropped, falls back here, and look at Sage out quicking Gabriel here. Bowled him over there with the somersault to the outside. Landing on his feet, again, the athleticism of Sage Matthews. Now we might see the youngster fly once again here. He does, but landing on his feet, nice roll as Gabriel getting out of the way. Oh, and tripping out the back leg, landing face first on that turnbuckle. Oh, into a back suplex. Yeah, but You almost saw a victory there. With that huge suplex, you can see the pain in the spine. Landed on the mat, sending those jolts through the nerves. He's able to recover and get an elbow in the corner. Matthews getting the boot up as well. But didn't quite clear all the cobwebs out, and there's the side slam. Again, Matthews showing that fight, even a little bit of a shove. A dismantling clothesline. Again, driving face first into the corner. Now a head of steam here from Gabriel, but able to move out of the way is Sage. With the back suplex attempt, landing on his feet. Or is that kick to the midsection? Wow, what a shot to the face. Pump kick. Oh, what a roaring forearm. There, but there's that sick kick. The sick kick putting away many a competitor here and now making his way to the outside. Could we perhaps see the blockbuster? Oh, instead, the high cross body block, and that does it. Out of nowhere, and both men laying the boots to Matthews here. Oh, the pump kick.
Thank you. What are you doing? You got a match tonight?
Must be the fire that he sees in this kid. Well, the effort is certainly there. And in terms of experience, there are few better than Bilvis Wesley here at the MFPW. There is the sound of the bell. Well, Bender wanting little to no part of Bilvis Wesley here. And for that matter, neither did Burke, as he didn't want to tag in. So now they lock up here. Standing side headlock by Bender, but Bender just picked up off of his feet. At least for a moment. Backed into the corner here. And a shoulder tackle sends Bender backwards. Trying it again, and this time Bender goes down. Oh, and an elbow as well. I mean, Bender giving up just over 100 pounds. And now tagging to Burke here, but ready to a left hand from Twitch, and out goes Burke. And he takes off Bender, but he's grabbed by Twitch. Unbelievable. These guys cannot be on the same page for their life, though. And you see a difference of opinion between the two partners, Burke and Bender, on the outside here. Now Bender trying to even things up in size. He's calling for the kid here, and there is the tag. Here comes Twitch to Sangro. You see the counter of the waist lock into the top wrist lock there, or the standing wrist lock, I should say. Nice roll through by Bender, and now he's got the arm ring. Oh, Twitch getting rather fancy here. Although I don't know what was old school about those reversals on Twitch's part. Considering that I got it last week, that would make sense here. Is the leapfrog now by Twitch, and hip toss, nicely done. And Twitch wanting some more Bender. Bender thinking the better of it. A couple of arm drags there, this time hanging on with the arm bar. Say he's got the rhythm. That's it. Well, they're looking for the victory here to avoid the Blues, and wow, Burke with the knee. Oh, into a power slam. Possible tandem offense here is, yes, the double suplex. Burke wisely pulling in for the cover, trying to keep Twitch from making the tag, but only garners a two. Belvis almost getting into the action here, but referee trying to send it back. Meanwhile, more double teaming here. All it took was a twitch. Birkin, nice suplex, float over, hooks the leg. Only a two. And again, Bill is trying to get in. And again, some cohesion here between Burke and Bender. Now claiming that they made the tag. Referee didn't see it, but. Bender now laying in here. Huge body slam. As if his nerves weren't shot enough. Can't speak too much to that medically here as Twitch delivering an elbow or two into the midsection here. One of those left forearms of his, the southpaw. Burke trying to make the tag there. And quite possibly. Both men now looking for the tag. And both men get the tag. In comes Bilvis and Burke. Huge clothesline here. He is fired up. Bilvis is going on top of Burke and Bender. Jesus, clothesline. Well, now looking for the tag here. No rest for the weary. Back in comes Twitch. Double whip, and both Burke and Bender collide in the middle of the ring. What a devastating forearm by Burke. The whip here, counter. Burke just launches Twitch. They almost collided again there. Oh, but now the O'Connor roll here, able to hook and get the victory. Thank you. F Live Championship. Brandon Soriano on a tear as of late. Vertical base of the Greek Beast up here. Come on. Oh, but this time he had it scattered. He catches the leg. Leg trip. Right into the head. Finding a better way to put it for the viewing audience here. And wow, look at the power, the attempted power bomb, but able to wriggle free is Soriano. And you hear the Freak be saved that close. Shoving him to the corner. Schoolboy roll up here and 2.5.
Come on, Nick. Come on.
Freak Beast almost showing a bit of surprise. This time putting on the brakes, but right there with the arm drag is Manny Soriano. Drop kick between the bottom and middle ropes. Able to take the big man down, at least for a little bit here. Trying for that dive through the middle rope, but right into the right hand of the freak beast. Power slam. And I thought the champ retain. Guess is as good as mine, Chad. Stepping around the room. We've seen this before. Slingshot over the ropes. Might we see that? Never mind, spear. Oh, the foot's on the rope.
You know, we saw that going
This man is Hyena Corey Hex, a very colorful individual, to say the least. As the bell sounds here, Matthew Omen. Now Gabriel here at ringside. Both men tie up here. And quick waist lock and a shove. Omen just blaring at Hyena and Corey Hex. As they lock up again, this time Omen with the arm wringer. Able to spin out and counter it is Hyena Corey Hex. Counters here, and now a roll through, split underneath, and right into the standing side headlock. Well, Omen now powering out of it, going back to the arm here. Seems like everything Omen tries to do, Hex has a counter. Ooh, well, hook of the tights there. Leapfrog, high leapfrog there, going for the hip toss, but blocked and do a backslide perhaps. Wow. Gabriel looks on the outside. Area there as Gabriel looks on the outside. Looks to the far side. Leaping forearm. Hex looks to be on spaghetti legs here and drop them with that back suplex. Savage Land is all that hot. Able to get the leg up as Omen running in here. Oh. The backbreaker, and then just putting the force on even more on the base of the spine. Certainly done here to Hyena Corey Hex. Oh, trying to get ahead of steam, but right into a Samoan drop. Quite possibly. Either way, that drop came all the way from these Savage Lands right to the base of the ring. Laying those right hands in, but thrust kick to the midsection. Falling in, delivering a forearm, able to get some offense here, just a diving headbutt. Continuing to innovate his offense here with the running double knee. And two. Kip up from Hyena Hex. Oh, and there's the springboard moonsault. But get him out of here. There's the Omen Slam.
The match is over. You have to take a minute to control of this. Ladies and gentlemen, I have received word that Headbanger Thrasher is not here.
Oh,
by the shoulder tackle there.
Thank you.
double team maneuver there and able to tag in the spider. Oh, and over the top goes Kensington. Well, no love lost between Riley Shepherd and Gabby Slays. Toss here, nicely done by Rex. Oh, and both girls, same idea with the drop kicks. Hanging on, trying for the O'Connor roll and going for the kick there. Schoolgirl attempted. Where's the referee? The referee's taking selfies. Gabby Slays taking. I understand social media is important, but. Oh, missing the charge in there. Now Rex with the. The front handspring. Running in and driving the boot. Oh, and an elbow as well. A lot of speed and athleticism. But, wow. Very methodical count. Oh, and a double clothesline. Get this over with here. Wait, she just went to three. What? Yeah, but when do they get to 10? That... Sending Rex in. Reversal here. Ducking the clothesline. Kick to the leg. Into the midsection. Going low, middle, high. Perhaps seeing that left knee there. Cross body block, but wow, she is caught. Oh, and a fall away slam. Level up. That handspring splash into the corner. And now here's the cover, the hook of the leg. But again, Gabby Slays distracted. Oh, and a shove. Double clothesline.
In stereo.
Oh, and a double suplex on Gabby Slays.
These two should be wrestling one another, not the official. How do they expect to get a victory on one another? Oh, looks like we have no contest this evening. Celebrating their hard-fought contest victory over.
to a little bit of a fitting of the title belt. The preliminary here, as a victory would have to occur first. Mikey Webb, no stranger to hardware here in the MFPW as the bell sounds. Former two-time the MF Live champion, former four-time the MFPW Supersonic champion. And counting as both men tie up here. Rochelle using the leverage advantage here and driving Webb into the corner, but we get a reluctant clean break. They're both known for their savvy competitorship, without question. And I'm sure that that's been well scouted by both contenders here. And now QT in the wrist lock here, roll through. Kip up, nicely done by Webb. He's got the arm here. Now QT with a roll through, trying to get a single leg, and before he's able to get the takedown, Webb goes into the ropes. Again now into the hammer lock. Well, it certainly is here, and fireman's carry takeover. Quick into the head scissors. Well, it certainly did the screening here at the MFPW Arena before one of our events not too terribly long ago. Headlock here, but countered into the hammer. Oh, and driving the knee down onto Mikey Webb's left forearm and elbow. And continuing to torque on that area with the arm bar. It's very methodical. No wasted motion on the part of QT Marchand. Again, torquing on that arm and shoulder. What makes Webb so dangerous and such a potential contender that he's in the spot that he's in. I mean, he can work with you in the ground game. He can go technical with you. He can fly. He can even mix it up with brawl on occasion. I mean, he that's why he calls himself the living legend and Mr. the MFPW. Time where he adds the MFPW's heavyweight championship into his title history here as the O'Connor roll only garnering a two. Wow! What a high waist lock takedown. Again.
No, it's just a champion.
flat. Webb certainly, not to discredit anything from QT Martell, he is the current heavyweight champion of the MFPW. He's held the title on two different occasions. Former tag team champion here at the MFPW.
And real life here, don't deserve
it. Oh no, not at all. I mean, both men deserve, all the accolades that they've earned and then some. But in the case of Mikey Webb, I will say, this is somebody who, not too long ago, endured a 60-minute Ironman match to win his fourth Supersonic Championship. So when it comes to endurance, when it comes to being able to stick it out, this is somebody who's right in there. He's been able to go the distance and then some. Lift up into a power bomb, and it turned into a head scissor, sending Marshall face first into that middle turnbuckle. And that's the thing about Mikey Webb. He is so innovative with his offense. Just when you think you've seen everything from him, he pulls something out of the hat that you haven't seen before. But you can also say the same thing for QT Marshall. Little baseball slide. Hear the ref say back in the ring, and that's certainly a stylish way to do so, skinning the cat and slingshot over the top and a crossbody knocking Marshall down to the ground again. Back in the ring after a little bit more damage being done. Going to the top and...
Oh, and almost...
Wow. Dropping Marshall all of his weight, both knees, right under the torso. And being able to back it up. That's something new for both of these competitors. No question. Another right hand sending the champ staggering to the corner. Devastating forearm as well. Mikey Webb going for a sound check here. Oh! I think that just angered him more than anything. Right hands as well, and now that just incensed the champion here, but running in with a head of steam right into the boot of Webb. What a drop kick.
Reaching the
Webb on Dream Street, seated perched on that top turnbuckle. On another forearm for good measure. Well, that steel post, not the comfiest of pillows, to say the least. Both men perched. Dangerous territory here. Marshall on the middle rope. Webb on the top rope, but able to slide out. And oh! Taking the legs out from underneath of Marshall. And Marshall landing in a very precarious position. And the neck breaker to follow. Still clutching onto that surgically repaired neck is the champion. And just being dragged up to his feet by that aforementioned neck. Courtesy of Mikey Webb. Right hands now by Marshall. Oh, and a right forearm as well. Trying to send it to the corner, but reverse it again. Back first. What you need is the apron here is again a boot. Continuing to go after those cervical vertebrae. The wiliness of both of these individuals. Oh, but trying for the left hand there, and oh, wow, a cross face here. Might we see the champ tap? Trying to roll out of it into a pinning combination, and that's able to get separation. Oh! How did he kick out of that? Driving that upper back right into the knee, continuing to deal the damage on that spinal cord. Now wrenching back on the chin. Getting behind the champion, QT Marshall, delivering an elbow and a forearm to the midsection. Making a trifecta, but again, driving that elbow right down on the neck. Wow, the forearms. bring Webb up for that tilt-a-whirl slam. There, able to get out of it as Webb, and now springboarding from the second rope of the corner, but caught by QT Marshall. And a power slam. Going into the high rank district here. Trying to swing for the fences perhaps here, but taking a little too much time and once again getting crotched, this time on the top rope. Marshall just looks absolutely stunned here. And now Webb going up to the top rope. Oh! Hurricane Rana looked like took a little bit out of both men, but Webb feeling the adrenaline back up on his feet. Powerbomb! Sit out powerbomb and a... No!
Only two! How in God's gift name did Mike Webb kick out of that?
I have no idea, Chaz. Charging in and almost colliding with the ref. But wait, here's a schoolboy. Looks like he has the tights possibly. Trying for the O'Connor, hanging on. And
a kick to the face of Marshall. Oh, one, two, and two. Wow. Oh, man.
He had gotten all of that crescent kick, but it wasn't quite enough.
This matchup is insane. You know what, Burgundy? This isn't even a pay-per-view.
That certainly is quality of that nature as Webb back up on his feet. QT staggering, hanging onto the ropes here. Trying to gain a little bit of momentum, but no, QT hanging on. Still trying, QT having none of it. The kick missing, and oh, what a right forearm. Tried to slam through, getting him out of the way here. A knee right to the chin. And there it is, that... Backstabber and a cutter.
And oh, and two. Marshall kicks out. Marshall kicks out.
I can't believe it.
The champion just kicked out after that vicious exchange. Wow.
Just when I think I've seen it all, I see something I've never seen before.
QT.
Webb thinking this is his time to ascend to the top of the MFPW. The heavyweight championship. One of the few titles that has eluded him here at the MFPW. Oh, trying to go for a neck breaker there, but trading forearms. Oh, getting the big boot up. Side slam, driving Mikey Webb right onto the ring apron. For that sliced bread there. Here now he had, oh! And there's sliced bread! No! Down that right knee pad, exposing the knee. I wonder what he's going for here. Oh, springing to the second rope, but QT Marshall catching him there. Oh! Webb planted again here. Can this be enough? No, Webb wisely rolling to the outside of the ring. Was that instinct on the part of Mikey Webb? Could he have known that perhaps if he had not rolled out of the ring that he might have been pinned for the three count? Was that just momentum? Marshall laboring to get Webb in the ring. He might be out. Wait a minute, playing possum here and going back into that cross face. Trying to roll through, but still holding on. Wait a minute. What's Rico de la Vega? The Beast Cartel, what's he doing here? Who knows what his intent is here, but it allows Webb to break the crossface. Wait, here's a scoop. Oh, but
QT Marshall doesn't want to win that way.
flipping him in here. And oh! The Cartel Kingpin has fallen down to the rock bottom. And wait, springboard kick. We have a new, what?
We have a new champion. We have a new champion. Mikey West.
Both men giving it their all. It could have gone either way, but it has gone the way of the challenger, who is now the champion. Oh, but wait a minute. There it is, the show of sportsmanship after QT yanking Mikey Webb down, and to the victor goes the spoils. And the spoils go to Mr. the MFPW, Mikey Webb. Certainly right about that, Chaz Williams. And for Chaz Williams, I'm Perron Burgundy saying, stay classy.
Hold that for me.